Hey everyone, Caleb Danzy here with Danzy Design Build, and today we're going to be talking about plans and design. What does it take to get the plans and design done for your basement finish, and what does it cost to do this? So in the planning and design process, the first thing that's important to understand is the team. Who are you going to be working with? And in selecting a team to work with, it's important to first choose or find a design build contractor. And the reason why you'd like to get in touch with a design builder first is because the design builder is the one who will be responsible to coordinate the entire design process as well as the actual construction process when the time comes. So get in touch with the design builder who can do that. The other reason why you'd like to get in touch with a design builder is because he will have the actual knowledge on the actual prices, what it actually takes to build basement finishes in the market, what is actually costing on a day-to-day basis. And then the benefit to that and having that knowledge up front in the design process is that sometimes designers and engineers can get really excited about really good ideas and they do a really good job at designing awesome spaces, but without a realistic vision of the costs, those designs can grow to be outside of your budget. And so to keep the design in budget and functional with your needs and wants, it's important to get a design builder in right on the front end to make sure that everything that's designed actually works for you in the end. So after the design builder gets on board with you, the next thing that is going to happen is probably need to get in touch with an interior designer. And another benefit to working with a design builder is that they have a network of people who they work with to do the interior design, to do the engineering, to do the drafting, and then, of course, to do the actual construction when that time comes. So the next team member will be the interior designer. And the interior designer can go through with you and look at your basement and help you decide what areas will be best used in which ways. You know, would it be better to have a bedroom over here or a kitchen or a theater room or a hallway, and just how a whole floor plan will actually work to provide you with the most value for your home and then also the most functional space to actually live in and enjoy. So that's the interior designer's primary role, is to help figure out and decide what will be the best layout of the space. Something else that interior designers can do is help you with the colors and the layout of the flooring and choosing the actual materials and selections, light fixtures, cabinetry, styles. They can even get really detailed and go into furniture planning, and a small part of interior design is actually decorating. So if those are things that you're needing help with, then the interior designer will definitely be able to help you with that and get a really good whole design package put together as far as the interiors. So the next thing that is going to happen is actually taking measurements. We'll come in and take measurements of the basement and then be able to put down on paper the size of the basement, calculate the square footage, and be able to draw in those rooms that we've been talking about with the interior designer. So that's the next part of the design phase. And in order to do that, a lot of times we will actually use a 3D scanner and use LiDAR to actually capture data points of the existing structure and be able to have a 3D model of the existing or pre-existing structure, or what it is when we're starting with the design. So from there, we can load that model into our 3D design software and actually be able to lay out the floor plans and do the actual design. So the next member of the team that we'll use and we'll work with is the actual structural engineer. And we may not need a structural engineer on your particular basement project, but the times that we'll actually need a structural engineer are when we are removing a load-bearing wall and replacing it with a beam, or if we are actually moving a load-bearing wall over a certain amount of feet. Sometimes that can work, and that's something that the actual engineer is going to calculate and based on those calculations, be able to determine if the structure can do that. So it's important to get the structural engineer on board as well, so that we can get a pulse on the pricing and the cost to actually move those walls and what it will actually cost to do that. So once we have our team in place, we can actually start in on the planning and the design. So we're going to make a number of sheets for your design of the basement and the actual plan set. And the first sheet that we'll draw is the architectural floor plan. And that is going to show the whole basement, all the rooms, the sizes, the shapes, and show the square footage of the basement. And we'll note that on the plans, what the size actually is. That's important for the city to understand what the size of the basement is. So for permitting processing. So when we get done with our architectural sheet, the next one that we'll draw is the structural sheet. And this will show which walls are being demolished or removed or changed in a structural sense. And then also, if you're doing a basement walkout, we'll show the footings, foundation, and the stairs leading to the exterior of the home, as well as the hole that we will cut in the foundation wall for the actual door to fit in when we put the walkout door on. So that will be on the structural sheet, and that is what the engineer will use to help determine the calculations that he'll do and the drawing that he will produce and stamp and sign as an engineered drawing. So that's the engineering structural sheet that we'll provide. The next sheet that we draw is a electrical sheet. So the electrical sheet shows the electrical components of the home, starting with a picture of the existing electrical panel. It's important to put that in the plans so that any electricians can see that and be aware of the existing panel, how much space they have left in that panel, and how many circuits they can put in there before they need to add a sub panel to have enough circuits and breakers to do the entire basement. So depending on the size and the electrical needs that you have, that can vary. So the first thing we put on there is the picture of the existing panel, and then we also show the floor plan of the basement, and we locate the location of each outlet and each light switch. And then we also show which light switches will control which lights, and if they're going to be three-way switches or whatnot, switching from multiple locations, such as in hallways or whatnot. We'll also show the actual light fixtures and detail whether those are going to be can lights or surface mounted lights. Can lights being recessed up into the ceiling, and then the surface mounted lights can be regular light fixtures of your style. Also decorative lighting, accent lighting, and task lighting. Task lighting on the cabinetry can also be shown on the electrical plan if that is something that you're looking to have done as part of your kitchen. So when we get done with the electrical plan, the next plan that we do is the mechanicals plan, which consists of the HVAC and the plumbing. So that will show the locations of the bathrooms, the existing piping that you may have in the basement floor stubbed out for plumbing. And also the HVAC side of things will show the existing trunk lines for the ductwork, and then any additional lines that we'll have to do. And typically we put supply lines out by every window. And the reason there is so that the coldest air in the room and the hottest air in the room can meet, and then leave the room feeling nice and warm and comfortable. So that is the HVAC and mechanical plan. So the next plan that we'll do is actually a cabinetry plan if you are having a bathroom or a kitchen in your basement. And that cabinetry plan is going to show the floor plan and elevation of the cabinets. And so that's going to show the size of each cabinet box, whether it's 12, 18, 24 inches, for example. What size are those cabinets? How many are there and where are they going on the walls? And then we'll also show the inside of the cabinets. What's inside there? Are there shelves? Are there drawers? Are there a combination of both? Or is it just nothing? Like underneath the sink, typically there's not any shelving. So we go through and we show that detail with the cabinetry. So the next plan that we'll draw is the finishes plan. In the finishes plan, we'll show things like flooring, tile, LVP flooring, carpeting. We'll also show the locations of those floorings, where they start and stop. We'll detail a little bit of the transition strips. Are you looking to have a no transition strip, a basic transition strip, or like a matching transition strip that will go along with the actual flooring? So those are some of the things we put on the flooring. And then also, if there's like a kitchen that kind of transitions into a living room and there's not really a door to the kitchen, we'll also show where in the room does the carpet stop and the hard flooring start. And so with this drawing, we're able to calculate the actual square footages of each type of flooring so that we can really provide accurate pricing to install and supply those types of floorings. So we'll also show on this drawing any special details as far as the trim and molding package that you'd like to go with. Are you having a typical baseboard and door casing package, or is it more custom profile? We can show those here in the plans and get those decided right up front on at the beginning of the project. So that will also be on the finishes plan. And then the next thing that we do is, we don't do this all the time, but we can offer a 3D rendering of the interior of your basement. And so if you're looking to have a really visual experience and really understand what this is going to look like when it's done, before we even start the construction, this will really help you be able to get a really good idea of what the flooring, the countertops and the cabinetry, you know, what's the hallway and bedrooms going to feel like. These renderings can show you exactly what that's going to look like with the lighting and the colors that you choose. So they can get a little bit pricey, sometimes between $1,000 and $3,000 to do the interior renderings. But if you're looking to see what it's going to look like before we ever start, it's definitely for you. So one other thing that we do before we're completed with the plans and design is we actually write the specifications and selections. And so this is where we actually go through and we make all the choices for the basement. What kind of flooring? What type of tile? You know, is it a 1 by 1 foot, 1 foot by 1 foot tiles, or is it 1 foot by 2 foot? Or is it the small, you know, 3 by 6 subway tiles? What are we doing? All of those things have different costs and different labor rates because they take different time to install and different attention to detail required for each type of flooring, or really everything that goes into the basement. So going through in the specifications and selections and choosing everything that you'd like to have done and then putting those in the design allows us to provide a really exact pricing as to what the basement's going to cost with the choices and the specifications that have been made. So the all in total cost for doing a design like this process that we've explained today, it typically costs somewhere between $1,500 and $2,500. Now on the low end toward the $1,500 mark, that's probably going to be because there's not a kitchen, there's no interior designer or engineer involved. And so we don't have to do the cabinet planning and design, and we don't have to do the interior design and structural engineering. So that can save some money on that end if it's more basic, simple design process. If you're looking to do a kitchen, do a basement walkout, and have an interior design, the interior designer help lay things out and decide how it will be done, the price increases a little bit to more toward the $2,500 mark. That's not the most that I've seen basement design cost. I have seen really extensive projects where the engineering alone has cost a couple thousand dollars. So in general, somewhere between $1,500 and $2,500 is a good estimate and a good ballpark number to plan on for a good solid design without any extreme situations or circumstances. So before we start the design process, we can identify anything that would be out of the normal and let you know what the actual cost would be to do this design process for you in your situation. So I hope you've enjoyed our video today. Our next video in the series will be our third video, and it will be about the city permitting process, why it's important to actually get a permit for your project, and then how long does that take, and what's the process, what does it look like, and who will be in charge of doing that, and what's the best way to navigate things moving forward into actually building with the city building department. So that's going to be our next video. I hope you've enjoyed watching today, and we thank you for your time. Have a great rest of your day.